together. There's a mona. Hello.
Tito Boy?
Ken.
Oh, Jenny ka! Ba? Hi, Tito Boy. Ganda ng suit mo ah.
Oo nga.
Hi. Terny yung hair sa suit niya.
I-cut yun ha. Joke.
Kinda getting nervous, man.
Ken, maraming salamat.
Thank you, Tito Boy. Thank you so much.
It's been a while.
It has.
Tagal natin hindi nagkita.
Yes, bro.
Kumusta ka?
I'm fine. I'm great.
Bakit gumagwapo ka? Ang hirap sagutin.
Yeah, I don't know.
How's mom?
She's fine. She's fine. She's great.
Send my love.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Hindi mo na-miss ang pagsayaw?
I mean, of course I miss it. You know, of course I miss.
You understand the question. Diba? Kasi pag sinasabing Enrique, parang Ken, I almost attach you to dancing.
Yeah.
Not that you don't act. You're an actor. Pero so what do you do? I mean, when you're not able. So what do you do when you're not able to dance because you have a lot of acting jobs?
I just really love music a lot. Uh-huh. So I just really love music. You know, since I was a kid, my parents kind of noticed like, gusto mong pabili ng Walkman. You know.
Okay.
And, even till now, I still listen to music every day. So I think, you know, just listening to music, it's a love of the music. I think that's why I love dancing also. It's just
so,
really the
paano
music.
Yan? Sa bahay na lang?
I just listen to music in the car kasi lagi in traffic. So
okay.
On the way, you know, wherever I have to go, I live in the south and my work's here in QC. Mm-hmm. So, you know, whenever I go back home or come here, I always listen to music and I, you know, sometimes I groove and dance, but...
But it's the most you can do. Just
yeah, or in the house
just...
sometimes, you know, just with friends, you know, just in the room, you know, where friends are.
Doon ka na lang sumasaya.
Yeah, and recently I've been dancing, you know, with Liza and my sister Bruce. They've been like huge K-pop fans. Recently, they're huge K-pop fans, so they've nothing but K-pop been playing in the house.
I didn't know this.
Yeah, and they know the steps, so sila pa nagtuturo sa akin. Eh, balita, usually ako lagi nagtuturo sa kanila.
Okay.
So they're teaching me, you know, so it's kind of good. And I think I just really miss my Sundays. With my family.
You miss your Sundays.
Yeah, I think I've been,
Ano yung pinaka-latest na K-pop? I'm sorry to cut you there.
Yeah, it's fine.
Ano yung pinaka-latest na K-pop step na natutunan mo mula sa sister mo at kay Liza?
There's different groups, but their favorite group is BTS.
Of course,
so
yeah.
They're showing me like the idol dance, like...
Which? Paano?
It's like, something like that. It's, they love that, you know. And then Blackpink, the Do It. They just had a concert here, so.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah,
ang nagturo sa yun yan.
My sister and Liza.
Your sister and Liza.
They're the one who taught me everything.
How close are they, your sister and Liza?
Super close. They're like,
super.
They're like best friends. I think. Minsan nga, pag pupunta sa
they don't gang up on you.
They do. Yeah, girls will always be girls, you know? So, they always gang up on me. You know, minsan sinasabi ko pa nga, oo nga, pag pupunta sa bahay yan, hindi na ako pinapansin, diretso na kila Andy sa mga barkada niya.
Right.
And, you know, they just talk about K-pop. I'm just messing around. I'm just kidding, but, you know. It's just good to see them, you know, get along all the time.
So. Now, I'm talking about friends. Nadalaw ho dito si Joro sa TWBA a couple weeks ago. And then, naikwento nga niya that you guys are friends or barkadas
yeah,
actually at
yeah,
a certain
yeah.
point. The South Boys.
The South Boys, yeah.
Diba? Joros,
Ketchup,
Boy 2,
Vandal. Yeah, actually, I really got shocked na, you know, naging ka-close ko sila. At that time, I was really close then with Ketchup kasi I was with him in Princess and I. And then after that, I met Joros and all these guys and we played basketball together, mga liga-liga.
At sa pag lumalabas daw kayo noon, wala pa
yes.
si Liza noon,
yes,
ikaw daw
yes.
yung OP.
Yes, kasi lahat sila laging
may mga dates.
I was just there all alone, but you know, just boys will be boys, you know, I just want to play basketball, have fun.
Right.
Kasi that time parang, you know, I was working. I didn't really have connections with my classmates and my old friends, so parang... Sila yung pinakamalapit na friends ko that time. So I think that's why I was really hanging out with them a lot.
Kanina lang, we were talking about the South Boys. Mm-hmm. Parang hati yung debate kanina sa dressing room. May mga nagsasabing, cool, what's the word, Mark, that you used?
Steady
lang.
Yeah.
Meron naman mga nagsasabing iba ang dating ng mga South Boys eh. Nasaan pa talaga kayo? Who are you guys? There's something about South Boys. I don't know why people are talking about them.
I think we're just super laid back there, you know? That's
why
I love. Yeah, we're just super laid back. Like, we go out and we just wear shorts. where pambahay lang, when we just go to the supermarket, go to the mall sometimes. Uh-huh. I mean, I grew up in the South, so sabi ko, you know, it feels, when you live in the South, it feels like you live in the suburbs, you know, and then like QC is like the
main. I like the word, laid back.
Yeah, super laid back, and I just feel like, you know, it just feels so relaxed there.
Pero dumadami na rin kasi mga restaurants, right, the bars,
yes,
you know.
Grabe na
dito. That area.
Yung traffic, lalo na sa Aguirre.
I know, as opposed to the years probably when you were growing up, na meron na rin, pero hindi masyado.
Not, yeah, hindi
masyado. Ngayon, Aguirre is what?
It's
diba?
It's crazy. So, yeah, but it, you know, it's still the same. Not at, you know, not night times, but it's yeah, still the same. You know?
Pero kayo nila, Joros, hanggang ngayon, nakikita-kita pa rin? Once in a while.
No, actually, mas nakikita ko pa yung anak niya. Like, one time, I started walking to my property dun. Kasi,
that's right in front of his house? Or
yeah, because that's where we keep all our cars. Tapos, I just place a little basketball court. You know, pag exercise lang, papawis. And I would see his babies, you know, nag-umiikot lang sa park. So
hindi yung tatay yung baby ang madalas makita.
Yeah, kasi pili ko busy din si Joros, so but yeah. I would text him, bro, kasama ko yung anak mo ngayon. Eh, bro, nasa taping ako. Tapos when he's at home naman, he invites me. Ako naman nasa taping, so.
Pero wait, you know, when Joros and I were talking about you, we talked about you apparently investing on properties.
Yes.
Ano ba to? Bahagi ng plano? Is it something that's deliberate? What is this? Are you investing for the future? What is this?
Yes, I'm really investing for the future. I mean, since my dad passed away, it really hit us hard. We weren't really prepared for it. You know, it's hard going through something like that. That's why I had to enter showbiz. And
naalala ko pa, dala-dala ka ng tatay mo.
Yeah, sapal everywhere. So, lahat. You know, it was really hard for my mom. For sure, for my mom.
And you don't want that to happen again?
I don't want it to happen
again. Can you say that again?
Family,
after
so.
Ricky passed, your dad passed on, life was hard.
It was hard, yeah. It was hard. I mean, we didn't really expect it. I was in college and, you know, my brother was in college, my sister was in elementary.
Oh.
And it was just super fast. So nobody really expected it, you know. To see your dad, the strongest guy in the family, to just, you know, to pass away. Yeah, it was hard.
So you have that resolve na ayokong mangyari ito muli.
And to be honest, I think if my dad didn't pass away, I don't think I would have entered showbiz. It wouldn't push me.
Saan ka sana?
I have no idea.
Alone Maybe, Together kasi tackles many what ifs,
yeah,
di ba?
So, I think I'll be studying something more about animals.
Kung hindi,
about nature.
Really?
I was just intrigued, you know, growing up, I loved animals, nature so much. I just feel like that's the true beauty of, you know, our planet, not buildings and stuff, you know. I mean, it's beautiful, it's an art, but I mean, the real essence of our planet is out there.
Pero you realize na noong bata ka pa, gusto ng tatay mo mag-artista ka.
Well, he was joking also to Tito Bongbang.
Yes,
eh. Kinukwento
yes.
niya na, pa, artisan mo yung anak ko. And you know, it's just funny that nagkatotoo.
He just adored you.
Yeah, so I'm just, as I said, like, if my dad didn't pass away, I don't think it would push me enough, to be mature enough.
And to take care of the family.
Yeah.
Ken, paano mo inaalaga ng pera mo? Aside from the investments.
It's my mom.
Bambi.
My mom, she's the boss. I mean, my mom's the mom and the dad right now. So
right.
Yeah, so when I was young, you know, when I was first, I wasn't really earning much when I entered showbiz. But the little money that we had, my mom was just, yeah, I wanted to buy a car. I was like, oh, wag muna, Ken, just trust me. So whatever little money I had would go to, you know, properties on the side. And then I think just, like a year ago, 2 years ago, like a year ago lang pala, or not even like a couple months ago, I just found out that my mom said that, you know, I just almost fully paid everything.
Wow.
And that was like, I'm 10 years in the business, and I think it was like 8 years ago.
Right.
And, you know, just simple living lang, you know. I wouldn't buy fancy cars.
Right.
And nothing. So I think, you know, just you have to be a little sacrifice. But in the long run, you know, it'll be better.
Right. And you and mom have become a team.
Yeah, it's my mom talaga. Kasi kung ako lang talaga, siyempre, I want to buy a car, paporma, you know. But it's my mom who keeps my head leveled. So it's all from my mom.
Grounded, diba?
It's my mom.
Pay tribute to mommy.
That's my mom.
Yeah, and did you mature faster because somehow, to a certain extent, you have become man of the house?
I felt like it, but I didn't want to feel it. See, that's the difference. I mean,
correct.
I felt it, but I didn't want to feel it.
Yeah.
You know, I felt it a lot. Like, I felt like I had pressure on me. Even till now, you know, like, if I want to invest more, like, sometimes times are not as easy as other times.
Tama.
the pressure's on me, you know. And
yeah. Kasi may mga bagay na kaya ng mom, 'di ba? Yeah. Pero may mga perspektibo na nakikita mo rin coming from where you are. So yes. I said it's really a team. Mm-hmm. 10 years in the business. 10 years, right?
10 years.
May mga panahon din ba Ken, na napapagod ka?
Yes, po.
Was there a time in your life when you just wanted to walk away?
Yes.
Meron din.
Not really walk away, but you know, maybe like a year off. Not even a year off, like a couple months off.
Yeah, I know.
Parang you just get to a point na, like, everything's like so, you know, everything's like fast forwarding to me, you know. I was just, I even told Hobie, like, I think we're not really cut out for this. You know, I even told Hobie, I think she's also one of the reasons why I'm still in here. Because Liza's here, and my family is there. I think if it's not for my family, I wouldn't even be doing this.
Tama.
Yeah, I mean, I was really pushed in to get into showbiz because of my dad.
Asa kaminsan, you have no right, wala kang karapatan mapagod dahil
exactly.
Alam mo yung purpose kung bakit ginagawa mo ang ginagawa
exactly.
mo.
Exactly.
Di ba?
And that time kasi nung, well, the biggest factor was also my grandma. Like I said, when my dad passed away, as soon as my dad passed away, we went all back to his room and we started to pray because he passed away. And we found out my grandma had cancer. So that's what pushed me more, like
right.
to push us. I remember that story I told
yes.
you. So yeah. before the properties, all my money would go to her first. And when my parents would get, they would fly sa pal. So pag wala sila, it's always my grandma would, you know, basically
right.
raised us. So she was like my second mom. So I was so shy. Even kasi sa workshop dito, acting workshop, I would even cut classes.
Talaga?
I would cut classes. And I remember my dad even getting mad at me.
You would cut classes because...
Cut acting workshop.
You were just so shy.
I was so shy. It wasn't really me dito. It wasn't
Talaga?
Me. It wasn't me.
Why? You were insecure about... things?
Maybe because growing up, I was like the only guy who looked different in school. So, you know, I didn't really think about it too much, but you know, you can see, you're not blind. So mm-hmm. maybe I just felt like, you know, the odd one out all the time. Not necessarily, they won't make it feel it, but in the back of my mind, but on myself, it was weird, but you know, that's why I felt. So I just felt like I don't want to belong. So I'd always put myself, you know, on the side. Show all the time.
Pero
so,
ikaw ang may kagagawa nun.
Yes.
I don't want to belong. I'm different. I don't belong to
yeah,
you.
Yeah, you know, this. Uh-oh. You know, when you're young and, you know,
right.
you get those feels and that's how I felt before. So, I just felt like, you know, I couldn't really
How did you move
much.
Beyond it? How did you move beyond the shyness?
When my dad passed away and uh-huh. then my grandma was there and I knew my mom couldn't really, you know, she was having a hard time, so may nag-offer po. And, you know, like, this hiya. I mean, mas mahihiya ako if I don't help my family.
Tama.
So, I mean, yeah.
Well, the good thing is, it's over.
Yeah,
I mean,
that's why.
Your work in progress.
Yes,
pero,
thank God.
Di ba, padahan-dahan nalalampasan.
Yes, po.
Okay, let's go to hashtag kung saan photos. I'm gonna show
man.
You some photos and tell me the story.
Okay.
Tell me the story behind these photos. Let's start with this one.
Whew. Kung saan na in love siya sa akin. Deja lang. <joke lang. laughs> Kung saan.
This is when? 20?
14.
14, okay.
Kung saan.
Tell me the story.
Kung saan nagsimula ang forever namin.
Oh.
100%. That's,
kung saan nagsimula ang forever, pakipaliwanag nga yun.
It's weird. Like, I mean, before I met her, I had a past girlfriend, but I said, you know, after that, sabi ko, you know what? I'm not gonna court anybody. Hindi ako magmaliligaw. Ayoko ng girlfriend till I find this girl. And she'll just come, you know? Because sometimes if you search for something, you're searching because you want to search. But sometimes, you know, if you don't search and it comes and you just don't know,
okay.
then you don't have a reason why you wanted to be
okay, so it. Why did you know that Liza was the one when you saw her? Pagkatapos ng pangakong hindi ako manliligaw.
It's not even when I saw her, it's when, you know, we were in Baguio, we didn't have any phones and, you know, walang signal, so we started to talk and she started to make kwento her life and I don't really know. At that time, I didn't really know, but...
So was it in Baguio that you fell for her?
Yeah.
Was it in Baguio when you first told her, I love you?
I wasn't. I was in Australia.
You were in Australia.
I was in Australia. Coming from taping, I had the tour with Sila Gerald, and I went to Australia.
And she was there.
And I wasn't even trying to think. No, she wasn't there. She was.
She was
in
here
Manila, yeah.
In Manila. Okay.
And she was with us. And for some reason, I just like, I just couldn't stop thinking about her. And I was in Australia. So I go, "Pata iba na to, ah."
So. Ano yung ginawa mo? You went to the phone.
I called her up on the phone, and then I said, "You know, it's kind of cheesy. I couldn't stop thinking about you." And sabi ko, "Yeah, I think ito na ata to. I don't know, but I love you." So
ganun ko ba?
So
I love you.
Yeah,
okay. Ganun. That's the first time you told her that. What did she say?
She didn't. For 2 seconds, 3 seconds, she didn't say anything, and she said, "I think I like you too. I love you too." So I was like, and I was in Australia. I was like, "Wait, I gotta go back home, man. I gotta go back home." So
uwi na tayo.
So
okay, let's go to the next photo. Kung saan hashtag kung saan.
Kung saan, doon ko nalaman na hindi niya ako iiwan kahit anong mangyari. Mm. At alam ko na she knows me. Kung saan,
kilala, once and all.
Once and all, kilala niya ako.
Uh-huh.
And kahit people would judge me, she knows who I was. She knows who I am. She was there, she knows who I am. And that's all I need to know. As long as one person trusts me and she knows truly who I am, okay na sa akin yun. As long as I know truly kilala nila ako.
Pero di ba, pwede kang lumuhod sa harap ng Diyos at magsabing, "Salamat po, I have this girl who believes in me."
Exactly.
Di ba? Mm-hmm. Wow. Let's go to the next one.
Kung saan natupad yung pangarap niya na makapunta sa Paris and sa Disneyland.
First dream time. Talaga niya.
It was her dream.
Talaga. Euro Disney?
Euro Disney was my first Disney when I was a baby. And it was her dream to go to Disneyland. So I took her there. Yeah, took her to Disneyland.
What can't you forget about this trip? Okay, so you went to Disney and then...
Kasama po yung family niya. Ni
at
Liza.
Family mo?
And family
was Bambi with you, your mom?
Of course she was, okay. Yeah, of course. I never go around without her. So my mom is...
Ang sarap kasi dahil kasali ang mga pamilya niyo dito sa inyong pag-iibigan.
Yes po.
It's wonderful.
I know.
So, diba?
Yeah, it's a big group, but you know, I wouldn't have it any other way.
Okay, of course.
Yeah.
Okay, so Disney, Paris.
Disney, Paris.
Very expensive city.
We went to Spain. Pinakilala ko sa family ko.
I remember that story.
Yeah, for the first time, you know, I nagpakilala ako sa family ko. So I think that was a big, big step. Yeah. And my abuelita, she's something. So, you know, for her to come out and say, "Oh my God, I'm in love with her." She told me, I was like, "I'm done." And my dad's siblings, oh, they were all there.
That's all I needed to hear.
Yeah, and they all loved her. So I think, I'm good.
Okay. Hashtag.
This is... Kasi nobody really, you know, nobody ever really surprised me para sa birthday ko. Except po yung mga ibang mga fans po namin. But she planned all of this. She surprised me. And I was so surprised.
And the story, and the truth is, ang hirap mong masurpresa.
Hirap mong masurpresa.
So, you know, Liza was...
Para magaling sila kasi nag-surprise sila the night before.
Talk about this. Saan to? Paano nila ginawa ito? Bakit hindi ka na-surpresa?
Well, na-surpresa.
No, I'm sorry. Bakit na-surpresa ka finally?
We were in my beach house kasi whenever we have, you know, pag Holy Week, my birthday, doon po lagi kami sa beach house ko. So, we were there for my beach house and they surprised me the night before. So, para small lang, you know, yung susana lang ako sanay, okay. Yung may handa lang si mama, may cake. So, they surprised me. And so, I thought that was it. Kasi, di ba, pag may surprise, right. Tapos na. So, konti lang, masaya kami. So, the next day, my birthday talaga mismo, I was asleep, and she said she had to go somewhere for work. I was like, ah, so sad. But I wasn't expecting anything. Kasi nga, na-surprise na ako. So, it really took me off guard. And then...
Yun pala,
they went to my other property, like a Hector... So they set up everything there. Kasi buti wala pang, you know, I didn't really build anything on it yet. So
the party was there.
At least kasi I didn't really experience also my property. So it's also thoughtful of them to put it sa property ko pa. So
galing.
At least, you know, it was something. All my friends were there, like people from showbiz and people, you know, ang layo din ng biyahe, may boat pa, so I was really, really touched.
Wala talagang nakapagsabi sa iyo, no?
Wala talaga. I swear to God. I swear, it was my first time.
How did you go there? How did they convince you to go to the other property? What was the excuse?
It was my mom's sister, Tita Gina. She just, I love her so much. She just had a stroke. My sister came up like, Ken, tara, let's go down. Let's picture tayo sa bangka. Ikot lang tayo sa island. I'm sleeping, please. Ayaw pumayag. They used my Tita Gina. Kami said, Ken, please. Okay, tita. Siyempre, I couldn't say no. It's my Tita Gina. So, sumama ako. Hindi ba ako nakasuot ng underwear? Kasi nakatutulog ko kasi naka-boxers lang ako pagdating ko sa bangka. May mga banda na gumagano'n. Kasi, oh my God! Sabi ko, man. It was the most embarrassing, but you know, it was the best thing I had in my birthday.
Okay. Hashtag kung saan. Let's talk about your movie.
Kung saan bumalik ang lahat.
What does it mean?
Well, this picture is, you know, it was 8 years after our first meeting sa movie. So, kung saan bumalik ang lahat. Yung pagmamahal ko sa iya. She's my great love. In real life and in the movie. So, I think that's the scene where we see each other for the first time in 8 years.
May nagsabi sa akin na ito daw ang pelikulang pinaka-totoo para sa'yo. I mean, in the context of who you are. Is that true?
Yeah, I would say.
Paano? I mean, talk about your character and talk about Ken.
Like I said before, you know, I didn't really... I was really shy. Maybe a big part of it was I didn't really believe in myself. Mm-hmm. I don't know why, I don't know how, but... You know, you really, there's something like that. You know, parang you become an enemy of yourself, you know?
Okay.
You try to bring yourself down where you should really bring yourself up.
You get in the way.
You get in the way of yourself. Right. And I think it's, being hard on yourself is also, it's bad. But in a way, it also, you know, brings out the, you know, the best
the
out
best.
Of you too. Right. After, you know, you have to go through that low to get you to that high. So, the same with Raph, you know, at start, he wasn't a dreamer. Ang dream lang niya, kung makapasa, di makapasa. You know, he didn't really...
You're a student here, di ba?
In UST, biology.
What was the course again?
BS Biology.
Biology,
but
okay.
I don't really think he really took it up because he wanted to. Maybe sa family lang niya. His parents wanted to. I'm not even sure why I even took it up as my character as Raph. But, you know, I meet this girl who's a dreamer, who's an idealist, who wants to change the world, which is Tin. Mm-hmm. And, you know, if you see something kasi that, you know, wala sa'yo, and you see it in another person... It just, you know, it just draws you closer to her.
And she goes to the University of the Philippines.
Exactly. And
idealist.
Know, idealist. And, you know, I think that's what I fell in love with, you know. Mm-hmm. And then 8 years later, let's see kung did Raph really. And after we break up, you know, things get in the way, have our differences. So 8 years after, let's see if Raph is still the same guy. Did he change? Let's see if then changed the world or maybe the world changed her. We'll see.
Maganda yun, ha? Kung nabago siya o binago siya ng mundo. What is the most important message or messages of the movie?
For me, Tito Boy, it's really about, you know, it's about regrets, I think. And like sinasabi ko lagi, huwag mo isipin who I was. Isipin mo who you should be. You know, a lot of people even know... Even,
say it again.
Well, don't think of who you were. Think of who you
That's
should
true.
Be. You know, who I was, it's in the past. So, para sa akin, this is very true. There's a lot of young people in college, even old people, even people who are even still working, till this day, still don't know what they want to do in their life. And that's really true. You know, like, everybody was, you know, a kid before. Everybody had their dreams. I'm sure there's a lot of people na, when they grew up, even now, people who are working, maybe nakamit nila yung dreams sila, maybe yung iba hindi. Kung nakamit mo ba, o kung hindi, are you satisfied? Masaya ka ba?
Okay.
You know, so...
Daming layers noon.
Maraming layers, you know.
Daming layers yun.
Yes.
Masaya ka ba? It's an entirely different question. But I want to tell you, also in the context of the movie, that's why gusto kong panoorin yung pelikula dahil sometimes, maraming hindi alam kung bakit ginagawa ang ilang ginagawa. But sometimes it's also good.
Yes.
Sometimes it's bad.
Mm-hmm.
You know, sometimes
exactly.
it's bad.
Exactly.
There are people who start their lives or the stories of their lives from the past. There are those who start with a now,
yes.
looking forward.
Yes.
Diba?
Yes.
Merong mga nangangarap, wala namang ginagawa. Mm-hmm. Meron namang hindi nangangarap,
maraming ginagawa.
Maraming ginagawa,
yes,
di ba?
That's so true.
Ang galing. So, yeah. Tin and your character here, Raph. Is Raph.
Yes.
Ito yung inyong two very different people.
Two very different galing. People who fall in love. And, you know, it's just, it's also a view of people's dreams. And when you go to the real world, if those dreams really, you know, are still what you think, or if the world is what you really
Tama.
Think.
Why do you fall? I mean, funny question, but yes. I just want to ask you this. Why do you fall for each other in the movie? Two very different people, pero they nag-ibigan.
Yes.
They decide to fall in love mm-hmm. with each other. Bakit? May dahilan wala?
Sometimes, I don't know, for me, sometimes, you know, people who, you know, you really don't see yourself in, you know, something that actually you don't see in yourself and you see it in other people. And I mean, you like it. People really like what they don't have.
Okay.
There's something about it that people Total. Like. People are dark, they want to be white. If I'm white, I want to be tan. So it's...
Kulot, straight.
Kuso, straight. So, you know, people really want what they don't have because they want to experience it. They want to feel it too. So I think, you know, I think that's also part of it. But I was just really in love by her spirit, by her heart, and wanting to change the world because even though I didn't believe in it, but for somebody mm-hmm. to be this strong, this woman, which I wasn't. So I think...
Sino ang dapat kong isama pag pinanood ko ang Alone Together?
I think your whole family. I think your family would be. It's a very good, you know. It's about responsibilities. It's about your dreams. It's for everybody's age.
Okay.
To be in fact, it's not more about love. It's more about the problems. Not yung love po dito. It's also part of it. But it's not really revolving around it.
Okay. At lalabas kami ng sinehan. Na nakangiti, nagkukurutan ba kami dito? Nag-aaway ba kami ni Tito Bong? Ano ba ang?
Hindi naman. You become with hope in your hearts. You know, hopefully you'll be smiling, but mm-hmm. that hope will always keep you going the next day.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's really nice. I mean, coming out of the theater with that kind of a feeling, hopeful yeah. for what's going to happen.
And being mature and being, you know, accepting it. I think it's a very, very a brave thing to do.
Who is more intense in the context of love, Raph or Ken? You are more intense.
Yes. Oh, both, I would say. We're the same.
Halos magkapareho kayo.
Yes.
Si Raph at saka si Ken.
Yes, yes. If I love hard.
Was there a time when you doubted na sasagutin ka ni Liza?
Oh, yeah.
Talaga?
Yeah. At first, syempre, at first.
Kasi di ba coming from a shy boy, napaka-insecure.
Yeah.
You entertained the thought that
yeah, but you know what, of course I did, but I just really show her, you know, I really showed her who I was. I was just a fun guy, you know, like papatawa lagi. I'm not really trying to put a front on, but and I just really, you know, I really got it from my dad, and you know, I just really yeah. wanted, you know, I just wanted to show her that, you know, it's okay to, you know, spill ice cream in your shirt, it's okay to go out in the rain sometimes, you have fun, it's okay to have fun.
And she's a smart yeah. girl.
I she's mean, a given kasi yung ganda, smart girl.
Given kasi yung ganda, I always tell people, how beautiful is she? Every time I do an interview with Liza, people would say, how is she in person? And the first word that comes to mind, smart.
Yes, and yeah, it's very shocking because what she's been through in life. I yeah. think that's why she's such, you know, a beautiful person inside and out. She's so smart. She has a big heart and she's so strong. She's so strong. And I think it's really because of what she's gone through in her life, and I'm super proud of her. And I'm the luckiest guy I think yeah. in the world.
Sorry. Konti na lang.
I'm sorry.
Sorry. I want to ask my own.
Okay. Pawis na po yun. I'm fine. I'm fine.
Oo.
Yung ilaw. Alam po.
Salamat.
That's okay. So, so yeah, and you know, people really don't take me as, you know, the serious type, but you know,
yeah,
and I'm like the happy-go-lucky guy, but I take everything with me, you know, and I think really deeply. So, yeah, I think that's
yeah,
good.
Yeah.
People see me as just like the funny guy, you know.
Konti na lang.
Yeah.
Ngayon lang ako nagpa-bounce ulit eh. Sabi ko, pa-style lipos ngayon ito. Parang bagong
anong
style.
Anong last time pinag-usapan?
Rap for Ken. Nah. Did you ever doubt?
About Liza?
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah. Sorry, basa.
Sige.
Yeah.
Sorry. It's okay. Yeah. With a face like his, you can cover it with anything. It will still be the best looking guy in the world.
Standard ball.
You know where I was. You know where I'm coming from, Ken. When I ask you about self-doubt, when you know talking about Liza, because in about 5 interviews I do with young movie actors, tanungin mo, sino ang pinakamagandang artista sa Pilipinas sa iyong henerasyon? Siguro mga what 5 out of 5 or 4 out of 5 at the least, no? Her name would come up. Liza Soberano. So, but I'm not saying, I mean, I apologize to Liza if you're watching. I'm not saying that, you know, she's a trophy girlfriend, but top of mind. Top of mind, wow. Who's the most beautiful girl? Liza Soberano. So, I'm not saying that you're not worthy because you're also one of the best looking boys I've seen. You'll always be a boy to me. That's where I'm coming from when I ask, nagduda ka ba na sasagutin ka, na mamahalin ka ng babaeng ito who is considered by many, not just in this country, but
yes,
in the world.
Yes.
She's a Hall of Famer as, you know, the most beautiful girl, one of the most beautiful girls in the world.
Mm-hmm. It wasn't even, you know, it didn't even dawn on me that time. I mean, we were babies. I mean, you know, years back. So, I really told her this, like, I really fell in love with her when she told me. And she said she never really told this to anybody, but she told me about her, you know, her life and her life story. And I had no idea what she's gone through. And like, okay, oh my God, you went through this? Like, this girl, this woman? And, you know, I mean, to see her throughout these years of how a wonderful and amazing woman she's become, strong woman, it just makes me feel like the luckiest guy in the world. Not even her face, it's just,
that's true.
It's her personality and her heart. And I just, you know, can't believe that, you know, a woman this gorgeous inside and out really went through this, and she's here, and she's real, and she's mine.
Intact.
And she's
still
mine.
Work in progress, inspiring, beautiful.
And
how
just,
much
yeah.
do you love her?
So much. So much. I don't know. I can't explain how much.
It's a very difficult question.
It's yeah.
Ken, we've been talking about Liza for a long time. We've done conversations in the past. This is a simple question: yes or no? Are you officially together?
Yes, Tito Boy. Yes.
And I'm so happy for you.
Yeah, thank you.
And I'm just so happy for you.
Thank you.
That's why when I was saying, love is.
For me.
Yeah.
Love is unexplainable. If I can really explain what love is, I don't think that's real love. You just can't explain. It just, you know, if I say one thing, that's just one thing, you know, why I like her. But why do I love her? You cannot explain. If somebody can explain why you love that person,
yeah,
I don't think they really know what love is.
Pag sinasabing alone, what comes to mind?
Not being with her. Not being with my family. And that's what scares me.
Pag sinabing together.
Happiness. I always like to be together, you know, with my family. I can't even travel alone. I cannot. I cannot. Mm-hmm. I have to be with at least one friend or my family or with Liza. I just can't. It's not in me. I just like to have somebody there. Like other people can travel alone, you know, but I mean, what's the point in reliving those memories if you're just alone? I'd rather be with somebody.
Taking it off from the movie, hypothetical, 8 years from now. So that should be 2027. 8 years from now. Not 5, am I right? Yeah, okay, 8 years from now. Nasaan ka?
I'll be in my dream home, hopefully, my dream home. Hopefully with a family.
Sinong kasama mo?
He said, of course, it'll be
Si Liza po yan.
Anong ginagawa?
Taking care of business, traveling, just enjoying life. Enjoying life.
And happy together.
Happy together. Of course, happy together.
Of course.
That's all I want.
And never alone.
Never alone. Never alone. Never I cannot. Alone. I cannot.
Complete the statement. Liza is.
She is. She's my life right now.
I am Enrique Hill and.
I'm Enrique Hill and I'm the luckiest man alive.
Maraming salamat, Ken. Invite everybody
yes.
to watch the movie.
Yes, mga pamilya, please, I invite everybody to please come by sa Trinoma po bukas for our premiere night. I hope you guys can please come by and see us there. And if you have a chance, please watch on February 13 po yan. It's our first showing of Alone Together. I hope you guys watch it. Bring your family, your loved ones. And I promise you guys, you will take something home. Have a little smile and maybe a little tear in your heart. But the most important is, may mauwi po kayo. And hope, people, hope. Thank you.
Maraming salamat.
Thank you.
I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
If your dad were alive, he would be so proud of you. He would be so proud. And of course, your mom, Bambi. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, thank you very much.
What? Voice of La Carmela de Baracay, thank you. Doctors Man and Pai Kalayan, thank you. Sa lahat ng inyong tulong sa amin sa Make Your Nanay Proud Foundation, maraming maraming salamat. Live and love in abundance and always make your nanay proud. Be kind. Abundance. Good night.
Make your mama proud.
Make your mama proud. Thank you.
Oh my gosh. Napawisan ako.
Nanay with Boy Abunda.